The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, began to implement its Office of Coast Survey 5-year raster sunset plan to replace paper nautical charts with electronic navigation charts in 2021.
NOAA uses a geographic information system to create accurate data-driven electronic charts, resolving past mapping errors and making it easier to keep boaters safe with up-to-date information on marine hazards.
The ability to quickly update electronic charts helps track areas that change frequently, such as turbulent waters near mouths of rivers or silt builds up into shoals.
A major storm can rearrange everything that was once familiar about a port or channel, impacting even the most experienced mariner. GIS provides NOAA with the ability to rapidly update charts in response, making these changes available to all boaters immediately through ENCs.
The move to GIS has also allowed the Office of Coast Survey to remain productive while cartographers work remotely in response to COVID-19.
Chart makers have the tools available at home to update charts protecting safety at sea by accessing the latest and most authoritative data, just as they would in the office.
Boaters are now being officially notified by the U.S. Coast Guard local notice to mariners as traditional paper charts are replaced. Cancellation of all paper and raster chart products will be completed by 2025.
Meanwhile, a NOAA custom chart web application is now available, which anyone can use to create and print their own paper charts using NOAA's data.
For recreational boaters, the custom chart application provides a whole new set of capabilities, such as entering the draft of a boat and producing charts that show exactly where it can safely travel.
While operators should continue to reduce speed when navigating unfamiliar waters, with frequent ENC updates, proper seamanship, and modern onboard navigation systems, they can navigate the unknown with greater confidence. With onboard GPS and electronic charting systems, position updates are instantaneous.
Aids to navigation, or ATONs, are also important tools for enhancing safety on the water. Unlike roads and highways on which we drive, waterways do not have road signs to tell us our location or distance to a destination or of hazards along the way. Instead, the waterways have ATONs.
An ATON, or nav aid, is any sort of marker that helps mariners determine their position with respect to land or navigational hazard or hidden danger. Traditionally, ATONs have been physical aids such as lighthouses, buoys, and beacons.
The introduction of virtual aids has been one of the greatest achievements in recent navigation history. A virtual aid to navigation does not physically exist, unlike buoys and beacons, but is created by a signal broadcast to the location to be marked in a waterway. It can be described as digital information sent through an automatic identification system from a transmitter. In other words, an electronic virtual marker.
AIS ATON stations broadcast their presence, identity, and status as a 9-digit Marine Mobile Service Identity, or MMSI number, at least every 3 minutes. These broadcasts can originate from an AIS station located on an existing physical ATON as a real AIS ATON, from a distant base station to coincide with an existing physical ATON as a synthetic AIS ATON, or to a location with no physical ATON at all as a virtual AIS ATON.
All three variants can be received by any existing AIS mobile device, but require an external display system for their portrayal. The basic symbol of a digital AIS ATON looks like a diamond shape with crosshair at the center on an electronic chart display and information system, or radar. Displays currently vary by manufacturer, but the intention is for portrayal to comply with forthcoming international standards. At the present time, virtual ATONs are usually deployed only until they can be replaced by a physical aid, or the navigational hazard is charted or removed.
Virtual ATONs have great potential to enhance safety. They are easy to implement and do not require costly physical infrastructure or maintenance. They can be moved with ease to mark new locations as conditions change and can be taken offline when there is no longer a danger.
A virtual ATON can be used in uncharted waters where it is not practical to place a physical aid. An AIS base station can be configured to send information to mark any location, enabling boaters to access the information in real time.
Virtual aids can be deployed rapidly in response to urgent circumstances. Their implementation can be completed in a short time to help mariners avoid unexpected hazards and dangers that may arise without warning.
Virtual ATONs are not prone to weather. Unlike traditional buoys or beacons, which may be missed by a mariner in fog or a storm, virtual aids will be detected and displayed on an ECDIS or radar overlay, even in harsh conditions.
In areas where physical buoys are seasonally lifted or may be subject to misplacement, or when a buoy is off station or damaged for any reason, virtual ATONs can provide an effective solution.
For recreational boaters, the migration to electronic charts is an important and ongoing change. And the future adoption of virtual ATONs holds enormous promise for greater safety when navigating waterways.